Hello everyone. In this video, we're going to take a look at one of my favorite apps, Cursor Pro. This is an app that I use when I record my videos, so if you've seen my videos before, you've most likely seen me use Cursor Pro. With Cursor Pro, what we're able to do is easily show our cursor, and we can actually highlight or magnify what is underneath the cursor. Now, you don't need to use this just for teaching like what I do. It actually just makes it easy to find your cursor. And it's available in the App Store. Let's take a look at Cursor Pro on the Mac. Now, let's first take a quick look at how I use Cursor Pro so you know what I'm talking about. When I move my cursor around, you're going to see that there is a blue ring that follows it. This is what Cursor Pro does. And not only that, when I hold down the function key, it'll magnify. So let's go over to this folder here. If I wanted to highlight this folder, I hold down the function key and it magnifies it. So that's basically how I use Cursor Pro. It makes it easy to find my cursor and I can highlight what I'm talking about. But there are other features within Cursor Pro. We can change the color. We can always show that blue ring. Let's take a look at these different settings. To do that, what we need to do is go up to the menu bar. So I'm going to go up to the menu bar here, and you can see there's Cursor Pro underneath that blue ring. Basically, all we have to do is just click on this, and then we go over to settings. Select it, and now we're looking at our settings. So there are three tabs up here at the top. We're going to go through each one of these tabs to take a look at some of these settings. The first tab here is the appearance. So this is the appearance of Cursor Pro. How large is the ring? What color is it? Things like that. We're not talking about any magnification or anything like that. It's just the appearance of the ring as we use it. So when we go down towards the bottom here, you're going to see we can change the shape. So when I select this, I can make it a rectangle. And now you can see it's a rectangle. I'm going to go back over to ellipse. That's how I like to have it. We can also set the size. I have it set for medium, but if you want to have it large, you can make it larger. And that makes the ring a little bit larger. Let's go ahead and make it small so we can kind of see the big difference there. So this is how you may want to use it if you're not in a teaching environment. You may want to have that cursor just kind of, or that blue ring, just follow your cursor around. I'm going to bring it back over to medium because I use it to highlight what I'm looking at. And then we can also set the border weight. Select this and we can change that border weight, the blue border. The border style, we can make it dashed or solid. And with dashed, it's not actually dashed. What it does is it puts just some lines here inside of that cursor. You're going to see there's some lines there. So it doesn't actually make the line dashed. It adds some little lines in there just to highlight a little bit. I think that's a nice little touch. But I'm going to leave it at solid here. And then we have a glow. There's not much difference here, at least that I can see with glow. Maybe it's the colors that I'm choosing. But what this will do is this will put just a little glow outside of that ring. I just leave it at hidden. It makes it nice and flat, which is what I like. And then we can set what happens when we click on it. Now, when I click on it, let's go over here to the left here. When I click on this, you're going to see that the ring shrinks. So right down here, it is shrinking when I click on it. Well, we can change that behavior. What we're able to do is set it to static so it doesn't do anything, and we can just hide it so it's not going to do anything as well. And then we can also set a perspective warping. I don't really care for this, but watch what happens when I click on this now. It's going to warp a little bit. You can see it warping there. I'm going to leave that off and just leave it for animated. And then we can also set the colors. Now we have three different options here. I have it as blue, and I'm just using a trackpad. But if you're using a mouse or a device, an input device that has multiple inputs, what you can do is you can actually change the color based on how you are clicking on that device. So if you have a mouse and you have a left and right button, the color will change based on which button you're using. Now I just have a trackpad, so I'm just going to leave it as is. I just like the blue there. So that's our appearance. Pretty simple stuff. Now let's take a look at our magnifier. What we need to do is go over to magnifier here. And then we can set our magnifier size. So this is the size of the ring. So it is not how far it is zooming in, it's just the size of the ring. So I have it set as large. Let's go ahead and make it small. We're gonna see the difference here. So we're gonna go with small, and you're gonna see that the ring there, when I magnify, covers that folder, but it's not covering or showing the entire folder there. But when I go to large, again, it's not how far it is zooming in, all it is setting the size of the ring. So now that ring is a little bit larger. We also have our zoom factor. So how far do we want it to zoom in? I have it at double, but if we go over to 20-fold, watch what happens here when I go over to work here. You're gonna see that it is really zooming in. I can't even get on that W there. So I really have to be precise because zooming in 20 times. I'm gonna go back over to my double. That seems to work well. And then we can set our quality. We have smooth and crisp. I like to leave it at smooth. Now, how do we set this magnification? How do we turn it on? When I go back over to my folder here, what am I doing to magnify? Well, that's where the magnifying key comes in. What I am doing is I am pressing the function key. So all I'm doing is just holding down the function key. Let's take a look at my overhead here, and you're going to see that all I am doing is pressing in on the function key. So I just have my finger down here on the function key, and I press on it, and we can see if you look at the screen, it is magnifying. So that's how I am turning on that magnification. Now, if you don't want to use that at all, you can also just turn this off. So that's our magnifier. So we know how to change the appearance, what it looks like. We know how to change the magnifier or set the magnification. And now we can set the behavior. When do we want it to show? So we go up here to behavior and we can set when it shows. So I have it hide when it is inactive. So when I go over here to the left and I don't do anything, you're going to see that that blue ring disappears. It is not there. Now when I move my cursor, it shows again. So it will show automatically or hide when active. Now you can also set it to hide when moving. So I select this, and now it is showing all the time, but when I move, it disappears. So you're gonna see it is no longer there on the left side, but when I don't do anything, it shows again. I start moving my cursor, it disappears. So it's the opposite effect. I like to have it show when I move my cursor. So I'm gonna hide when inactive. And then we can just have it always show. If I go to never, it is never going to hide. So I just move my cursor. We can see it's over here on the left. I don't do anything. It's not doing anything. It's just staying there. So now I just go back over to hide when it's inactive. That's how I like to use it. And then we can also have it beg for attention. So if I don't do anything, let's go ahead and make this inactive. If I don't do anything, we go over here to the left. Watch what happens here. If I'm not going to do anything, and now it's going to beg for attention. So you can easily see where that cursor is. Now when I move, it's going to go back to the standard appearance that I set. Now I don't do anything again. It's going to disappear. And now it's going to beg for attention. And let's go ahead and turn that off. I don't want it to beg for attention. And then we can set a hotkey to disable the app altogether. So if you wanted to turn the app off, I have found a few problems with some apps. Sometimes when you click on it, it doesn't actually click the button. It doesn't happen too often, but there are cases where it does interfere where I can't click on a button. So what I have to do is I have to turn it off. Well, you can set up a hotkey here to turn it off, but what I do is I just go up to the menu bar here, and then I just say disable it. And when I disable this, I can click on that button, and then when I need to use it again, I just go back up here and enable it. So how might you use this if you're not in the same environment like me where I use it for teaching? Well, what you could do is you could go to appearance here, and I would set this for tiny, so we always see the cursor in a nice small spot there. And then I would also go over to behavior here, and I would never hide it. And now that cursor is always going to show. It's never going to be hidden. It's nice and small. It's not going to interfere with anything. And if I do need to magnify anything, I just hold down the function key and I can magnify it. So that may be how you want to use it in your environment. So that is one of my favorite apps, Cursor Pro. I'll have a link for it down in the notes on where you can download it. It is available in the Mac App Store, and it's really not that expensive. I can't remember the price, but it's really not that expensive. If you always lose your cursor, this may be the solution. There are other cursor type apps out there that are like this, but this one seems to work the best for me. I haven't had any problem. I've been using this now for a couple years, and it seems to work great. So if you like this, take a look at the notes, take a look at it in the App Store, download it, and see if it works for you. So that is one of my favorite apps, Cursor Pro.